The tri-village of Mongmongtotomaiti is a peaceful area with the exception of the sounds of airplanes taking off and landing in nearby Tizen. Mayor Andrew Villagomez, who's seeking re-election, did not return calls for an interview. But MTM resident Tito Castro is hoping he'll be given an opportunity to lead.
I was born in Guyana, and I grew up here.
Castro worked for the federal government for more than 3 decades, and now he wants to serve and give back to the very community he's grown up in.
The position is to serve the community in any way I can.
He says the people of Mongmongtotomaiti are what make the tri-village so special, setting it apart from other villages around the island. It's why he's hoping to bring more recreation for the village youth.
What I notice is that I prefer to support the kids first and then support them because there's a lot of recreational facility are missing, like ping pong, tennis court, racquet court, mini golf for the little ones. And I also like to provide sidewalks because I noticed that kids walk right on the lane.
Castro would also like to adopt the JQ San Miguel campus and assist with providing preventative maintenance for air conditioners, leaving students and teachers in the heat. Along the campaign trail, he's also heard the concerns from residents firsthand.
I'll just pick up a lateral or a secondary road. They're about 45-degree incline. I didn't know about it because I don't drive down there, but the residents there says, can you help us with our road? Because when we're going up and we apply the brake, we start sliding back.
He wants to put up guardrails to protect motorists and make areas safer to drive, whether there's funding for it or not.
But I'm not worried whether they have enough money or not. I can, with my experiences with car washing, all that thing, 4 Saturdays, we can collect close to $4,000. It's enough to pave one lateral street that were neglected for 40 years. That is my belief.
Vote for me, ladies and gentlemen. With Tino can do, we'll do just for you.
Antonio T. Cruz, better known as Tontuba, is also running for Mongmongtotomaiti mayor.
I was born in Tabuning, but I moved here in 1962. And since there, I leave here for 50 years old, 50 years. People here are so friendly that there's they have some concerns about the village and stuff out there. All in all, this is a nice village, a beautiful village. And we could make it look better, you know, if I become a mayor.
Like Castro, Cruz is concerned about the condition of the roads in the tri-village.
Half of the old roads fixed, repaired. And also, I could see coming down the Biang Street, all this water trench, the ditches there, is very dangerous. A lot of cars fell into those ditches. And they've put non-skid on that area. Those cars won't slide all the way down from the hill, all the way down to the main road.
And it's not just the unsafe roads that has crews concerned.
All the stray dogs, you know, try to get the stray dogs out of the road, because when people like to walk and jog, the stray dogs chase them and stuff. And the community center, I like the community center to be repaired. If they can't repair it, then remodel, you know, break it down and look for some funds, some federal fundings, and have it fixed so we could have our senior citizens back. The Manamcos, back to their place.
Cruz urges constituents to vote for him, saying it's time for a change, and he promises to make a difference.
Well, the mayor's position is a kind of hard job. You tend to answer for all the people's concerns and problems, and the risk around money. I know I could do better for the village of Mongmongtotomaiti as a mayor. And if the people give me a chance and they vote for me, they'll see the difference.
We now head to the village of Tumantumanang Harmon, where we find Mayor Francisco Blas, who's looking to secure a third term. In the last 8 years, Blas says he's managed to clean up the village, touting the cleanup of a large dump site behind Shen's Furniture in Harmon as his biggest accomplishment.
I went there and I looked at it and said, boy, this is really bad. So, you know, with my experience down with the big Navy, I know how to handle and how to get it done. It's not a short time, it's maybe within the 6 months it was all clear. And the residents back there, they're so happy, you know, because it's about time that somebody do something.
Blas says he also focused his efforts on stopping the illegal dumping that was occurring at the old Guam Memorial Hospital and the metallic waste in old school buses that were on Adrian Santrez Street better known as Hamburger Road. While he managed to clean up the dumps, the mayor says he wants to see the repairs to Hamburger Road through to completion.
Yes, they identify the funding, but I don't want to say, I mean, you know, they said that they're going to work on it. But, you know, things goes, you know, I'm not going to say anything about others, but it wasn't done. But now I'm working with DPW, and, you know, they're telling me, and even I talked about with the governor, and they assure me that they're going to start, I think, phase one by the end of this year.
Blas says he's also working to fix secondary roads within the villages, and he's hoping that a sports complex will be built to service the growing recreational needs of his constituents.
We do need it, you know, like I said, the gym is very much occupied now when I got in. You know, it's, I wouldn't say 24-7, but it's 7 days a week. You know, my kids and I was so happy when I see young kids coming in there and playing now because of the place has been cleaned out and safety and everything's there. I want them to continue because I am not serving. I am delivering the work that I put out there.
Current Tumont-Mininghamon Vice Mayor Luis Rivera is hoping to be given the opportunity to step up and lead the village.
Being vice mayor, there's so much we can do, but we're still limited and have to respect the mayor because he has overall authority. And so now I'd like to give it a chance because there's so much that I can do. There's so many great ideas and creative things that can happen right now if given the authority.
Having been the vice mayor for the last 8 years, Rivera says she knows firsthand the concerns of residents and wants a chance to share her ideas to improve the village.
I love to work with the community, work with the youth, the Manumco, just everyone middle age like me, and you know, to promote programs, to bring in more programs, to make sure that all facilities are fixed right away when there are recreational places that have been broken, you know, to be able to make the repairs.
Rivera says improving the village will be possible with the help of the business community.
Having the public-private partnership is a wonderful thing. And so being a good coordinator, a good leader, is what it takes to be a mayor.
The biggest problem area that Rivera would like to tackle first if elected as mayor would be improving the safety of the roads, specifically the secondary roads that are plagued with potholes. She'd also like to focus on
the stray animals. You know, then of course you've been seeing a lot of people needing financial assistance that are out on the streets soliciting for money. You know, I go out there, try to educate them. A lot have to do with the mentality and education, being able to talk to them and letting them know what is available to them. A vote for Louise is a good vote for the community. Please vote for me, number 2 on the ballot.